got time, and she knows what to figure out. This ain't in a dream, a place where it seems that love will come around. So don't stay.
Good morning, everyone. So we are in the middle of November, and I'm out today to try to have some fun with autumn, or actually at the end of autumn. I didn't have, unfortunately, any time to go out before today. So I'll try to do my best to have beautiful autumn photos. Now, since 3 years, actually, I saw this tree, and since these 3 years, I haven't ever had the courage to try to take a photo of it, because it's so chaotic, so complicated. I don't want to include the sky, and I don't want to have a lot of this chaotic ground. It's so hard to take a photo of, but the tree itself is so beautiful. I think I saw only 2 or 3 trees like that in my life. There's a lot of branch everywhere, and it's really so beautiful. And every time I see it, I feel there's a photo can be taken here. Now, how I can take the photo, this is the secret, or this is the hard part, obviously. I was trying actually since 1 hour, half an hour before even taking off my camera from my bag. I was just trying to go around the tree and try to know where is the best angle, the best possible angle. After that, I take off my camera with my 10-20mm lens, and I am trying right now to choose the best angle, because I want to try to show as much branches in the photo as I can. Maybe I think the best way is to fill the frame with the tree itself, because if I want, or if I try to be a little bit far away from the tree, there will be a lot of sky, a lot of other elements, a lot of other trees that I don't want. I just want to focus on this tree. I want the main subject. I want to fill the frame with this tree, and I'm really still not sure I will be able to do that without having a lot of sky. So as you can see, this is the composition that I decided I may like, hopefully. So as you can see, I was trying to not cut off this trunk here, because I will include it, because it's a beautiful part of the tree itself. So from the other side here, I decide to stay here, to stick in this place, because there's nothing interesting on the left hand side. Actually, I went down as much as I can, because the ground is so chaotic, and there's nothing specific, or there's nothing interesting to include in the ground. Now, the thing that I don't like, actually, as I said, there's a lot of sky here. Now, the beautiful thing is that there's yellow color here, to know that it's autumn, actually. Yellow color and yellow leaves on this side here, but there's a lot of sky. Now, as I said, my fault that I'm trying to take the photo now and not earlier this year, to have the sky covered with the tree leaves. Now, talking about the photo, I will not make any focus stack. I am focusing only on the tree trunk here, and I'm using f11, so that's enough, because there's no subject so close, and you know, there's no two subjects, for example, one too close and the other is too far. It's only the tree, and f11, it's enough. No.
Mother's scared to leave her all alone. She got time, and she knows what to figure out. The scene in a dream, a place where it seems to love.
So this photo was taken exactly 1 month later. The conditions were totally different, and I was standing on the opposite direction. I made that on purpose in order to include the sun in the composition. Now, for me, actually, the composition doesn't work nicely good here. But I still like this photo more than the first one,
because of the sunrise. It made the atmosphere of the photo more beautiful. And on the other side, this is the first photo ever I could make, which has the combination of sunrise and snow. If you would like, don't hesitate writing a comment. Which one you find better and why?
This ain't in a dream, a place where it seems that love will come around. So don't stay.
So let me explain to you what I was trying to do here. As you can see, the color of the trees here are so beautiful. And the problem is that there's a fence, and don't be worried, the fence is safe. So I am trying to find only one tree, for example, and use my 7300 millimeter lens to try to zoom in and isolate the tree from the scene, because the colors are really so beautiful. They are like orange and red trees, and I can't unfortunately I can't find like these colors on other areas. So that's why I was trying just to go around here and try to find, as I said, only one tree to isolate it. I found actually one of them. I will try to put my 7300 millimeter lens and try to take a photo of it. I will go up the fence, because when I go down, there's a lot of small grass or leaves coming up from the ground, and I don't want them to pluck the tree. That's why I think I will go up and put my tripod right here and to take the photo only for the tree itself. So at the end of today's video, I just want to say, like always, thanks a lot for watching. I hope you like the photos. I hope you enjoyed the video. And I am really so sorry again for not uploading a lot of videos this year. I'm really so busy. Anyway, thanks a lot again for watching. Please consider subscribing if you are not already, and see you in the next video. Bye.